Hello everyone, I'm Mirko Panamente and together with my colleague Chiara Pezzari we're going to present our work. The concentric action recognition consists to work on data that are recorded by the user itself. The interest of the community grew very rapidly in the last year thanks to the release of large-scale dataset Epic Kitchen and due to the availability of new wearable devices and the continuous effort of various universities and companies to collect new data. Despite the huge interest from this setting, exists a strong dependency of the network with the environment when the actions are recorded. This issue is called environmental bias and limits the applicability of this model in real-world context. To understand better the importance of this problem, we show the performance of the top three ranked at the past Epic Kitchen Challenge. We can notice a consistent drop in performance when we pass from scene to unseen scenario. In this work, we want to exploit the audiovisual collaboration to solve this issue. We believe that the use of audio in this context is well justified. Indeed, this modality encodes complementary information with the visual one and does not suffer of the error motion problem. Moreover, in an environment like a kitchen, each object produces a characteristic sound during interaction with it. We believe that this information could be more robust to domain shift. And also, we consider this modality free respect to the optical flow information that requires a high computational cost. Even if the audiovisual input are rich of information, it's not guaranteed that using them in a multimodal fashion achieve an optimal performance. We notice that the network does not learn equally from the two modality. In fact, performance of the RGB stream degrade when training both modality jointly. Moreover, we notice that the modality which was privileged by the network was the one characterized by a greater mean feature norm. Thus, we brought to light the norm unbalance problem, causing the network to privilege one modality during training while penalize the other. To deal with this problem, we propose a new relative norm alignment loss. Given the visual and audio features, we know that the net mean feature norm will be different. We propose a new loss that reduces the discrepancy between the mean feature norms of the two modality, bringing the ratio to 1. By rebalancing the contribution of the two modalities during training, we increase the generalization ability of the model.
Here, I present our baseline. Given the input from both RGB and audio modalities, we fed them to a separate feature extractor, one for each modality. The RNA loss operates at feature level by rebalancing the mean feature norms of the two modalities during training. Finally, two different classifiers, one for each modality, produce a final classification for each input. The two are combined through a late fusion approach and the RNA loss is minimized together with the standard cross entropy loss. We follow the experimental protocol proposed in CVPR 2020 by selecting the three largest kitchens from the Epic Kitchen dataset as three different domains. We then evaluate performance under different settings, the single source domain generalization setting consisting in training on one kitchen and testing on unseen one. The multi-source domain generalization setting, where training is performed on multiple kitchens, and the unsupervised domain adaptation setting, where unlabeled target data are available during training. Here we show some results. First, we assess the performance of the single model streams separately, and then show that when combining them, we achieve an improvement by up to 5%. When minimizing the RNA loss, we achieve a further improvement by up to 4% in accuracy. We also show results in multi-source domain generalization by comparing ArenaNet against existing domain generalization approaches. We also show that ArenaNet outperformed very recently proposed multimodal approaches. In fact, it does not only improve the multimodal cooperation, but it also increases the generalization capabilities of the network. Finally, we compare ArenaNet against recently proposed unsupervised domain adaptation approaches and show that it outperforms the state of the art in first-person domain adaptation. This method also achieved the third place position at the Epic Kitchens Unsupervised Domain Adaptation Challenge held in conjunction with CVPR 21. In conclusion, we brought to light the norm unbalance problem and addressed it through a new audiovisual loss function. Moreover, we present the first domain generalization benchmark using egocentric action recognition and validate our approach on both domain generalization and unsupervised domain adaptation settings. Thanks, and if you have any question, we'll be here to answer.